Dear students, today you are going to learn a lesson from the literature reader book, chapter 6, Mowgli, the Wolf's Child, written by Rudyard Kipling. Joseph Rudyard Kipling was an English journalist, short story writer, poet, and novelist. He was born in India, which inspired much of his work. Kipling's work of fiction include The Jungle Book. Our story is taken from The Jungle Book. The story of Mowgli. Mowgli is a little boy who was saved by the family of wolves from the man-eating tiger, Shere Khan. Shere Khan taken away this boy to eat, but the wolves pack, the group of wolves, saved this child from Shere Khan. He is named Mowgli. Who gave this name to Mowgli? The wolves pack gave this name to this human being, this man child, that is Mowgli. The Mowgli was playing, hunting, and eating with the wolves pack, wolves group. But Shere Khan does not forget his prey. Shere Khan, once he loses this prey, he wanted to recapture the prey from the wolf's pack, and he was waiting for the all possible opportunities to get back the man child from the wolf's community. And when Mowgli grows up, turns the younger wolves of pack against him. Shere Khan was very cunning. He began to get the help of the younger wolves pack, newborn wolves pack. They were not friendly with Mowgli, and Shere Khan used the opportunity to catch this boy, this man child from the wolf's pack, and Shere Khan was successful in turning the younger wolf's pack against Mowgli. With great sorrow, Mowgli decides to leave the jungle and live amongst the mysterious thing called men. In order to save his life from the Shere Khan, Mowgli escaped from the village, from the jungle, and moved to a nearby village. That village is 20 miles away from the jungle. Let us begin the story. When Mowgli left the wolf's cave after the fight with the pack at the Council Rock, it is the Council Rock, the rock they used to call their meetings, The rock used to held their meetings, that is the council rock. He went down to the plogged land. Plogged land means the agricultural field. Plogged land means agricultural field, where the villagers live. But he would not stop there because it was too near to the jungle. So he hurried on, keeping to the rough road that ran down the village valley, and followed it at a steady jog trot for nearly 20 miles till he came to a country. Country here means a village that he did not know. He did not know the name of that village, and he covered some distance. Jog trot. What is jog trot? To go faster than a walk but slower than a run. In that speed he moved, and he covered the places like deep valleys, ravines. What is a ravine here? Deep and narrow passage created by rivers. Deep and narrow passage created by rivers. He was moving on that path towards the countryside. The valley opened out into a great plain dotted over with rocks and cut up with ravines. At one end stood a little village, and at the other the thick jungle came down in a sweep to the grassing grounds. Yes, after the dwelling place there is a vast grassing ground for the cattle for their grassing, and stopped there as though it had been cut off with a hoe. All over the plain cattle and buffaloes were grassing. Yes, all over the plain cattle and buffaloes were grassing. And when the boy, little boy in charge of the herd saw Mowgli, they shouted and ran away. The children who were grassing the cattle saw this strange boy. They ran towards their home to inform about the strange boy. And the yellow dogs that hang about every Indian village bark. You know, along with the boys, some dogs were there. When the dogs saw the Mowgli, they started barking at the Mowgli. Mowgli walked on, for he was feeling hungry. Yes, he was feeling hungry. He wanted to get something to eat because he was covering a long distance to reach the village. And when he came to the village gate, he saw the big thorn bush that was drawn up before the gate. At twilight, pushed it to one side. Yes, village, there was a thorny bushes were placed there to keep away the wild animals to enter the houses. He said, for he had come across more than one such barricade. What is the barricade here? The thick thorny bushes were placed there, grown there, to keep away the wild animals. He covered that place, and barricades in his night wanderings, movings after things to eat. So men are afraid of the people of the jungle here too. He sat down by the gate, and when a man came out, he stood up, opened his mouth and pointed down to show that he wanted food. Yes, a man came and was looking at the Mughali very sharply. He came to know that, he understood that this boy need food, need something to eat, because he was looking very hungry. The men stared, men looked at and ran back to the street of the village shouting for the priest. The men who saw the child, the boy first, who ran towards that place where the village priest was taking rest, and he went there, and along with that priest he came back. The priest, who was a big fat man dressed in white, you can see the priest is a big fat man dressed in white with a red and yellow mark on his forehead, came to the gate, and with him came at least 100 people. Yes, that man was not alone there, followed by hundred people nearabout, came there to see this strange boy, and who stared, all were looking at him, staring at him, and talked and shouted and pointed at Mughli. Mughli realized that these people have no manners at all. These people have no manners at all, because they are looking at me very, very furiously and staring at me sharply. Only the grey ape would behave as they do. So he threw back his long hair and frowned at the crowd. Yes, with this I am winding up this video. The rest of the lesson, rest of the story, you can expect in another video. Thank you. Have a nice time.